them. I hear. Get a plan.
Guys, last time we were out here, coaching staff didn't look what we saw. You all know it wasn't good enough. So let's make up for that today and have a great one. I know you got it in. Gentlemen, achieving our goal starts right here on the practice field. I can't stress that enough. You will know we have lofty goals for this season. If you want to
win,
I done came up, busting down the whole broke, step back. Want your people swag, ain't even gotta ask. What are those, what is that? Please don't touch my rap. Please don't touch my rap. I'm racked up like rappers, I'm wrapped up on camera. Get out on camera, squeeze weak like asthma. It's rare wrath when I wear wrath, bare wrath when I wear wrath. Might invest into some rap shit, look. Still shit rap, and I'm drippin' on rags. Rick gonna be the tag. Do the digital dash. Yeah, I'm boastin', never brag. Please don't touch my rap. Or the Chris Van Nash. Alessandra Gucci glasses. W Anderson collab. Yeah, you pop it like a. Yeah, you drop it on the. I'ma buy another. Cut the boys, bring it back. Yeah, you know how to make it laugh. Plus, us keeping tabs. I'ma fly first class. Wear them with it. Please don't touch my rap.
Don't step on my Ralph Simmons. Don't step on my Ralph Simmons. Don't step on Ralph Simmons. Do you know how much I'm spending? My closet, it worth about a million. To the little out the runway. In the kitchen. Ralph Simmons. All kind of crazy colors. Living color. Left wrist, roll it, roll ice. Mason, my gel on my sweater. Mama told me never settle. Ralph Simmons, don't lace them. Got your wanna.
Huh? What? Don't wanna talk about the pain. I swear to God, these be haters. They be hating, I feel out of the. Cul-de-sac, don't get along. Move right with my neighbors. Diamonds on my neck, early on. Now I later got under the flavors. I'm with my lightsaber. Ooh, feel like Darth Vader. I boss you, you know I might riff it. Ooh, rap in my basement. Yeah. But you know that I'm gon' face it. Wait, that's the reason that they mad. Cozy, yeah, he made it. Yeah, I wore that rap for I made it. Yeah, I wore that rap for I made it. Yeah, got that rap all in my basement. Yeah, yeah, got patient. Yeah, I'm famous. Yeah, put my side inside Marc Jacob. Hey, made no place with my label. I get it, I count it in my table.
Sterling silver laces. That's rubies red, my skin too black to blush, too red to. Six not pages. This ain't on the green, on the up. Pockets full of mint leaves. Been smelling like it brushed tea. Say cheese, see the porcelain. Water, see the backwoods. Raph dragging on the floor. In it, in it. I'm torching the road in these Gucci flames. Stuck to the pavement, they glued. I'm 2.5 million in the venue and 2,500 too. I'm cold like I'm sick with the flu. I cover my face and I'm that spring summer 2002.
Yeah, please don't touch my ride. When the grass teddy, with the teddy. Quick with the hands ready. Please don't touch my please don't touch my ride. Shirt on cam, ready. Let's dock in.
Ryan Quigley, fifth-year man from Boston College, in to punt it away. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted. And spotted at the 14-yard line. First and 10, here's Rodgers. And complete on the right side to Bennett. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Second down, here's Rodgers. Going left side here, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football out shy of the 30 to the 29. The numbers for him from a week ago. He catches 131 yards. Rodgers now on first down.
It certainly seems like he gets a touchdown each week, doesn't it? Here we are in the final month of the season. He is the NFL leader in touchdown catches.
He has been an absolute machine. Rodgers will try again on second down. Oh, nearly picked. Almost intercepted, but he couldn't hang on. It's third down. So we'll look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in, playing at a high level. That's when you know drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
And now, partner, he has surpassed Marvin Harrison's record for most catches in a single season. He's got 144.
It's amazing. He almost did quietly because Marvin Harrison wasn't a guy that we saw much in the media, but boy, did he produce. Now he steps aside. Marvin Harrison is number two. We were here today to see the new number one.
Just 2 yards to go here on second down for the offense. Rodgers to throw once more. Firing quickly here. That's complete. And he'll get it now this time to the 17. It's a 9-yard gain. It keeps the drive moving. Solid catch there for a man who's been so brilliant this year. Worth pointing out, as we were talking about earlier, there has never in the 60-year history of the award been a pass catcher, tight end, or wide receiver that has taken home the MVP trophy.
And the best receivers I've talked with, they know that stat, and it drives them crazy because they understand that without a quarterback, they don't make plays that they make. They also don't feel like they get enough credit for feeling out some of the throws the quarterback's made.
Yeah, absolutely. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers.
Drive we just saw that culminated in a touchdown, exactly what many offenses are looking for. Sustained ones that can impose their will on the other team.
Horvath out to kick this one away. This will be taken near the back of the end zone. Oh, he shifts past him. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. On first down, Rodgers. Wide open receiver complete. He's at the 30. Past the 20. Touchdown, Packers. A big play there. 77 yards. And the Packers are able to strike quickly for six. Yeah, he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
It's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already.
Here's Ryan Quigley now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And now a high kick here as he'll try to hang it up there. And not his best effort there, as this one's going to be spotted down just outside of the 40-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, we'll see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
They would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure no one gets behind you. That's cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
Back to the air on second down. Rodgers. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
But he kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't going through. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now. Horvath out to kick this one away. Now the return. Here comes Randall Cobb. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. The Packers get set to go. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position?
There goes Martellus Bennett. 20, 10. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Martellus Bennett, his fifth. As he's on to punt for Minnesota. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We're back to... Following these words, here's Ryan Quigley now as he's on to punt for Minnesota. He's been a busy man here in his first half as he gets it away. So that'll be marked down as a 19-yard punt. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe, the first and 10. First down, here to run with Montgomery. And he's brought down. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
I think many people thought Ty Montgomery would automatically go back to being a wide receiver this year, but it appears he's going to stay at running back. I know they drafted Jamal Williams from BYU, but Montgomery proving his worth.
And he proved it, yeah, proved it last year. 5.4 yards per carry, fourth best in the league. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic well over 100 yards.
We taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
He was waving his arms, wanted the football, but he dropped it. And that reminds me of a story you told me from your days at Tennessee. We don't need to mention the other guy's name, but when he dropped an open pass that you blew coverage, what did you say to him?
Yeah, it's really not right since I blew coverage, but since he dropped the pass, I said, well, maybe next time he'll just walk it out and hand it to you. Would that be easier? He wasn't real thrilled with that.
That's cold-blooded. Cold-blooded. Throw, it's Rodgers. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Randall Cobb. Here's Ryan Quigley now as he's on to punt for the fourth time tonight. And now a high kick here as they'll try to cover this one. And this will be down just on the other side of midfield. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Rodgers now on first down. There's that man again, it's complete. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters. Happy holidays, Larry. Your gift. Take a halftime show off, partner. We've got some football to get to. And a short kick, taking it about the 16. Just by him. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive. They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, but you can take the spirit away from another team. Their drive and will to come back and then can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
They'll get nine there as that sets them up better for third down. The Packers on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They're up against a third and one situation. Here's Rodgers to throw. It's caught, Nelson. And he will have first down. Yardage is brought down at the 41.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down. Executed it to perfection. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down. They got the win last week despite not having any interceptions. Tried to come up with one there. Could not. But there's a stat category called PBU, pass breakup. That's important, too. And they got one.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it because at least you're there knocking the ball away. Offense isn't possessing it, making plays downfield. And you just continue to harass the receivers, harass the quarterback, and maybe the big play does occur down the road.
He's going to float this one deep right side. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up. Here's Ryan Quigley now, as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And he'll take this in at the 1 yard line. Dances by him. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field.
This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
Rodgers again here on second and 10. Had his hands on it, but dropped it. The rookie making a little bit of a rookie mistake, third down. He was out there waving his arms saying, throw it here, dropped it, not a good look.
Well, all I can do is just look at him with contempt on that one. As a defensive back, I'm saying, not as an announcer, just like, really?
A little bit of a diva look, isn't it?
Yeah, very much so, because I think what happens is he just had too much time to think. He's wide open now, here comes the ball, and he doesn't concentrate and drops it.
First down, they run again. Here's Montgomery looking for an opening. Not much there. He'll get it to the 39. A gain of three, second down.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now Rodgers throwing on second down. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. Touchdown, Packers! A big play there. 66 yards. And the Packers add on to their lead. And partner, sayonara to Randy Moss's 0-7 record. That is the 24th receiving touchdown this year for him. He's the new king.
Well, always remember how Randy did it. Going deep, going over the top of people, and catching those touchdown passes. But what we've witnessed here today, what we've witnessed throughout this season, great new memories have been created by the new king.
From the gun, it's Rodgers. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. There have been no struggles here for this crew. I mean, they were up double digits at halftime, and they've just expanded that here in the second half.
And it appears there are no answers from the defensive side. I think right now, if I'm the coordinator, if I'm down on the field, if I'm wearing a hat, I've already thrown it. It's a visor, it's sailed, right? My game plan is down by my feet right now because nothing I've drawn up appears to be working.
Well, he's going to have to find something right now to stop this offense.
Well, there's times we see these catches that are made, and we just know the guy's playing it. Are really wishing for college rules. Only that one foot down instead of two. It's awfully difficult on the sideline, isn't it?
To throw is Rodgers, and he couldn't corral it. It falls down incomplete, but maybe not a big deal given this big lead. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll keep coming here with Montgomery. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back to 40. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Brandon, it's clear running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat the effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Rodgers handing to Montgomery. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down to 26. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game. What a nice play by the defense. Stepping up on that one. Maybe they'll get things going in their direction after a play like that.
Here's Ryan Quigley now. Time for a break. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk over. And he'll send this one into the cold Lambeau night. And this kick will be touched down as they spot inside the 45-yard line. Now trotting out there, the Packers getting ready to go. They have the big lead here. Late, they protected their home turf, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start the year.
On third down, they go Montgomery. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. A solid gain of 15 yards. Rodgers throwing here. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's actually gotten smart, and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to lead the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you got to run fast. Of course, you got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, the premium for all of that now.
Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of the points that were being put on the score. You're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know, people really enjoyed the.
I done came up, busting down the whole broke, it's the bag. Want your people swag, ain't even gotta ask. What are those, what is that? Please don't touch my wrath, please don't touch my wrath. I'm racked up like rappers, I'm wrapped up on camera. Hit out on camera, squeeze like asthma. Dread wrath when I wear wrath, bear wrath when I wear wrath. Might invest in some rap shit, look, still shit rap. And I'm dripping on